In the future, the world would be submerged in water. The value of soil could be equal to the value of gold. A cup of soil could be exchanged for a woman. The earth began to heat up, which caused the ice at the poles to melt quickly. The sea level rose and engulfed everything. Therefore, humans could only live on water and in boats. Trees and soil had become the most precious things. Humans had also never given up on finding new continents. The story unfolded from within this context. This was a mutant man named Kelvin. In order to survive on limited water, he could only recycle his urine. He turned it into drinkable water and used some of that water to water the lemon tree. While Kelvin was going down to the sea in search of food, there was a wandering man sneaking into Kelvin's boat to steal lemons. Seeing this, Kelvin asked him what he was doing on his boat. But the man lied and deliberately tried to escape. Seeing that, Kelvin was so angry that he broke the boat of that man. He even threw the towel into the sea. After that, he noticed someone coming. They were pirates. They wanted to rob things on the boat. Then Kelvin sailed to an island. But the owner of the island didn't want him in. So Kelvin took out his treasure, which was soil, to negotiate. Soil could be exchanged for anything. When the owner of the island saw that Kelvin had such a precious thing, he opened the gate for Kelvin to come in. The people on the island had never seen such pure soil. Kelvin could exchange it for drinking water. With such a large amount of soil, Kelvin asked for some other things in exchange. Then they took him to Helen's shop and asked him what more he wanted. Kelvin wanted a tomato plant. Although Helen didn't seem to want that, she had to give it to him. When he was about to leave, everyone on the island stopped him. They led to a woman, because they wanted to take his jeans. Everyone looked at him with strange eyes. However, he completely refused. He couldn't do such things in this world. This made the people on the island very angry. So they caught him, and then the two sides started fighting. While fighting, they discovered a very strange thing behind Kelvin's ear. So they thought he was a mutant. They thought that the appearance of mutants made the earth submerged in water. Not accepting this, everyone in the island surrounded him to arrest him. As a result, Kelvin was locked in a cage. That night, an old man named Rayala came to see Kelvin. He asked Kelvin where the remaining land was. Taking this opportunity, Kelvin lied to that old man. As long as he got out of here, he would show it to the old man. But their conversation was discovered, Rayala could only leave. The people on the island decided to execute Kelvin the next day. Although Helen and Rayala didn't want that to happen, they had no choice either. While they prepared to kill him, the pirates suddenly came. The pirates didn't come here just to plunder. They also wanted to find a girl like in the legend. This girl had a tattoo of a map on her body. As long as they could decipher this map, they could find a new place to live. At this time, the gatekeeper started ringing the bell to alarm. Everyone started to prepare to defend, but it was too late. The pirates started to attack. Under the onslaught of firepower, the island quickly fell into danger. At this point, Rayala used the hot air balloon that he made in order to get out of here. During the chaos, Helen saved Kelvin. But with one condition, Kelvin had to save her and her daughter, and then found a new place to live. In such an urgent situation, Kelvin agreed. Thanks to the intelligence, Kelvin got Helen and her daughter out of here. The pirates couldn't find that child, and knew Kelvin took her away. So they quickly flew over the sea to search for the three of them. Because the amount of fresh water on the boat was only enough for two people. So Kelvin asked Helen to leave her daughter. Helen disagreed and said she would use her body in exchange. The little girl doodled on his boat. Kelvin thought she was annoying and would damage his boat, so he was very angry. So he immediately threw her into the sea. Seeing that, Helen quickly jumped to save. Because of this action, Kelvin was regretful, so he let the two of them stay on the boat. Not long after, the pirates chased here. They saw Kelvin's boat and started attacking him. Fortunately, Kelvin shot at their plane. But his boat was also broken. Afterwards, Kelvin questioned Helen why they were always chasing the two of them. So Helen told him the truth about her daughter's tattoo. Hearing that, he was so angry that he even cut Helen's hair. After that, they met a man on the sea. He wanted to exchange something of value for Helen, and Kelvin agreed. After that, Kelvin and Helen talked for a long time. So Kelvin thought again and felt regret. And then killed that man. Kelvin threw him into the sea and took all his food. He then caught a shark. Therefore, their food problem was solved. They talked and ate together. The next day, Kelvin took Helen's daughter to swim with him. Their relationship was getting better and better. Kelvin told Helen that there were no more continents, because all were submerged under the sea. The land that he obtained also came from under the sea. However, Helen didn't believe it. Then Kelvin took her to the bottom of the sea and Helen finally believed. After a while, they found a trading station. Kelvin was hoping to exchange land for some equipment to repair his boat. But when approaching, he discovered that this was a pirate's trap. He quickly turned the boat around to run away, but it was too late. Kelvin and Helen were caught and Helen's daughter was lucky to escape. After that, the pirate leader threatened their lives. They wanted him to immediately hand the little girl over. To save Helen, Kelvin dragged her into the sea with him. At this time, Helen's daughter was also arrested. The two of them had to dive underwater for a long time until they left. At this point, the boat was broken and about to sink into the sea. Luckily, Rayala flew the hot air balloon and saved them in time. After that, they found other survivors at the trading station. Kelvin wanted to help Helen save her daughter. So Kelvin decided to go alone to save her. After the pirates caught the little girl, they asked for information about that land. But she refused to say anything. So the pirate decided to remove her tattoo. After that, they held a big party to celebrate this. They got a clue from the map on her body. The leader said as long as they could decipher the map, they would live in wealth. Hearing that, the whole group of pirates cheered loudly and prepared to take action. At this point, Kelvin successfully sneaked onto their boat. He began to negotiate with the pirate. If they didn't release that little girl, he would blow up the boat. Seeing that, the leader took the child with him and wanted to escape by plane. Unexpectedly, Kelvin used the crossbow to pull it back. At the time of danger, Helen dropped a rope from the hot air balloon. Grabbing the rope, Kelvin took Helen's daughter out of there. But the leader shot the little girl, which caused her to fall into the sea. Seeing that, Kelvin immediately jumped down to save her. And the three pirates collided and were blown up at sea. After that, everyone understood the meaning of the map. After a long journey, they finally found the continent. But when arriving on the mainland, Kelvin wasn't used to life here. Therefore, he said goodbye to everyone and returned to life at sea. Maybe he was suitable for living in the ocean. Through this movie, we also learned that the problem wasn't where we lived. No matter where we lived, good and evil would still appear in our lives. We would certainly find it difficult to avoid good and evil. But when facing difficulties and challenges, we just needed to have compassion, courage, and solidarity, then we would have happiness. The movie comes here. See you.